Now, back to Forecast Earth this week.
Hi, I'm Dr. Heidi Cohen. Each week, we highlight new eco-information that appears online, in print, on TV, or in the movie theaters. And this weekend, we bring you green content available in concert. Here's the green scene. The hot ticket in solar energy this weekend is a festival of music and renewable energy in Georgia. 30,000 people, 3 days, three stages, one of them running entirely on solar energy.
This is the first stage that you'll see when you come in.
Mark McClary and Neil Turley run Sustainable Waves, the company responsible for the green activities integral to the ECHO project.
Especially with the ECHO project, I think that it's very much a core part of the event and why people are coming out.
It starts with the tickets. You can pay extra for a green ticket that comes with carbon offsets to reduce your personal carbon footprint. As you come through the gates, the first things you see are an art display and a stage, both powered by mobile solar generators.
And we've actually brought several of those that will be powering elements of the event all over the event.
Biodiesel generators supply additional power, including for the main stage. Trash will be sorted for recycling on the spot. Concertgoers are asked to bring their old cell phones, PDAs, and other electronics for recycling. There are even a series of seminars and training sessions on ecology and renewable energy.
I wanted to give people the opportunity to actually put their hands, you know, from the solar panels to the batteries and see the magic of that electricity come to life.
The ECHO project has also teamed up with a local volunteer group called Rivers Alive for a series of cleanups of the Chattahoochee River.
I think it's definitely one of the driving aspects environmentally of what we were trying to do.
The ECHO project is the latest in a new trend of environmentally aware music festivals. Recycling was a significant part of Bonnaroo, a three-day event in Tennessee this summer. And Sustainable Waves has seen a surge in business interest in the last year.
Absolutely. I mean, we've just seen a boom since, and I would say, yeah, in the last 12 months, our business is just, we're extremely busy these days.
The ECHO project is here to stay for a while. Not only this weekend, the music doesn't stop until 2 a.m. Monday morning, but also this decade. They have a 10-year permit to hold the event on these grounds.